Gaz, want to recommend? It's from a new book, 100 Best Busking Ballads. And this is it with the harmonica.
We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun, but the
Tony, mate, how can I put this? Take your joy and your fun and bugger off.
Goes down very well in the subways, actually.
So does urinating and mugging, but at least people don't ask you for their small change when they've had a piss.
Just trying to make a living, mate.
I'm sorry, mate. It's all this Dorothy stuff.
Well, yeah, I know. You should think about something else.
Do you know what hurts the most?
Getting your balls caught between two bricks, got to be.
Do you know what hurts the most about Dorothy going off with this bloke?
Oh, no, sorry, mate, what?
She says she's in love. She never said that with me.
Oh, she doesn't love him. Perhaps he's just better with his knob.
Thanks, mate, thanks very much.
Listen, I never told you this before, but one day when we were down at the Crown, you were up at the bar, Dorothy leaned over to me and she said, I really don't deserve Gary. See? She respected you, mate. She loved you and she respected you.
I bet she was just saying, what have I done to deserve Gary?
Oh, yeah, that was it. Still, at least there is one positive side.
What?
At least I've got a girlfriend.
About time, too. I haven't had a girl for so long, I've forgotten which end to start. I tell you what, mate, chicks come onto me all the time when I'm busking. Hey, listen, I'm thinking of varying the act. What do you think of this?
We had joy, we had fun, we had the sun, but the hills had been cool.
So we don't like the bongos then, but I'm thinking of putting in some performance art as well. This is me walking in the wind.
Me smashing you in the face with the bongos in the wind.
Hey, guys, mate, guys, lighten up. Look, mate, do you trust me?
Of course I do.
Right, well, if you do exactly what I say, I think I can get Dorothy back.
What?
Well, you see, first of all, you've got to play hard to get. And that means don't go around and see her and don't phone her.
OK. Dorothy? Hi.
Oh, hello, Gary.
How are you?
Oh, I'm OK. What about you?
Oh, I'm OK, you know.
Gary?
Yeah?
Why are you phoning me from a brothel?
No, I'm at home, just lazing around, you know.
Oh. Have you got someone there with you?
Oh, no one special.
Oh.
I was just wondering if we could meet up for a chat, you know?
Yeah, okay, fine. Listen, it sounds like you've got people around.
Oh. People, person, dripping, pouting, love slave, whatever. Oh, I'm not making you jealous, am I?
Okay, can I stop doing these sucking noises now? It's doing it.
Gary, how about you phone me another time when you don't need to rely on a tray of props, a BBC sound effects tape, and your friend making sucking noises?
Yeah, okay. So what's so great about this new bloke, anyway?
Jamie. Oh, he's lovely. He's
got... Oh, God, don't tell me. Oh, I know. 5 years. 5 years we've been together. Doesn't that mean anything?
Oh, of course it does, Gary. You're part of my life.
Yeah, I know. That'll be surprising, is it?
Some of my things are still around at your place.
I know. There's a cheese sandwich in the fridge. Do you want me to post it to you?
It's okay, keep it.
Thanks. Tony broke your facial sauna, I'm afraid.
How?
He cracked it, steaming his testicles.
Oh, never mind.
It came out really well. I'm going to keep the things we bought together.
Well, that's not fair.
Well, according to you, life isn't, is it? If it was, Michael Portillo would have a big wart on the side of his head.
Look, you keep the tent, and I'll have the sun lamp and the Scrabble.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it? I'll get to huddle under some damp canvas while you and Mr. Lovely have all over tans and play an entertaining and informative word game.
All right, the other way round, then.
Well, who am I going to play Scrabble with?
Tony!
It's not the same with Tony. He alters his letters with felt tip.
It's difficult, Gary.
It's busking any day, doesn't it, eh? Hey, I've learnt the chorus to the birdie song. Shall I play it to you?
Oh, no, don't spoil it. We've had such a nice time.
Oh, well.
So, what's your secret? You've been like a stick of rock all afternoon.
What, Minty?
No.
Oh, no, I see, yeah. I've had a bit of a gap from women, you know.
Why?
Well, I've been sort of saving myself for the girl upstairs. My fluids have been building up for quite a while now. It's like when you open a washing machine halfway through the cycle and all that stuff pours out.
So why didn't she want to open your machine for you?
She's got a bit of a fixed idea of the kind of bloke she wants.
What kind's that?
Someone she likes. I mean, she sort of likes me, but well, it's like a swingometer, you know. Well, I mean, she likes me. She likes me less. Bit less, or a bit more. Oh, she hates me. Really, really hates me.
You got a light, Tony?
Oh, not that drawer. You can't... I really must tell Gary not to leave his stuff in my room. Brandy laps it up and gulps it down. Open wide and say, arse. I mean, is it me, or is that just degrading and offensive to women?
Don't bother, Tony.
No, I really must have a word, you know. It's the shock of Dorothy dumping him. I mean, these are the only women he can trust.
Does that really turn you on?
How can that possibly... Oh, yeah, it does, actually.
How can it?
She's naked.
Yeah, but she's obviously freezing to death. She's sitting on a forklift truck feeling exposed and stupid and like a piece of meat. How can that turn you on?
Well, she's naked.
Well, what's she got that I haven't?
Oh, nothing. It's just that, well, she folds up into a nice handy size and sits quietly in the drawer. Oh. Come on. I mean... We do come into the world in the nuddy.
Yeah, we don't come into it on our hands and knees, clutching a cucumber and pretending to have an orgasm.
So, you're not a big user of pornography, then?
No, I mean it, Tony. If you don't get rid of these, I don't want anything to do with
you. Look, it's simple. See, they just go straight in the bin over there. See?
You, do you want a drink, Emma?
No, thanks. I'm in the middle of cooking.
Oh, can I have some?
No.
OK. Let's see. Look, Deborah, you're a girl.
No, I was a girl and now I'm a woman.
How's that work, then?
Never mind.
Anyway, thanks for coming down. I just wanted to ask you, because as a girl, a woman or whatever, I thought you might have some insight into what I can do to get Dorothy back.
Oh, I know it's hard to accept, Gary, but maybe she doesn't want to come back.
Good, very sound.
Maybe you should think of finding somebody new.
OK, yeah. How do I do that, then?
You meet new people.
New people, like you're thinking.
Do you meet anyone at work?
Yep, there's a mad middle-aged bloke and a mad middle-aged woman.
Well, you could... I don't know, do some evening classes.
Well, wouldn't I be too busy meeting people?
You meet people there.
Oh, I see, yeah, good, got it, right. Well, what should I study? Fridge maintenance, something like that? Basketball?
Oh, Gary, this has hit you quite hard, hasn't it?
Eh? No, it's a bit of freedom. Just what the doctor ordered.
You could do what I'm doing tomorrow night.
What's that?
Give a dinner party.
Or should I come to yours?
Well, I've got enough guests.
But I could squeeze on the end.
Well, there isn't really room.
I could bring my own little table and put it next
you
to you.
You can't come, Gary.
I'll bring my own cutlery. I'll be no trouble.
You wouldn't want to come. I've invited Dorothy and her new boyfriend.
Oh, I see. I'll get the picture. Right, well, Deborah, thanks for the advice. I think what I'll do is I'll throw a dinner party at me own. Probably tomorrow night will be a nice night for you.
Won't you need more time to prepare?
Oh, Deborah, I can see you haven't organised as many sophisticated dinner parties as I have. Sodger.
George, remind me what I need for a sophisticated dinner party.
Guests.
Food.
Drink.
Anything else?
I find a bowl of nuts often puts a smile on the guests' faces in the early stages.
Nuts as well. This is getting complicated.
Anthea, who should I ask to my dinner party?
Well, Peter Ustinov's very chatty, isn't he? He'd make it go with a swing. Or comedian Tom O'Connor. He'd probably have a ready quip.
Great. Got any more suggestions? Whitney Houston, the Birmingham Six, perhaps?
Have you got enough chairs for the Birmingham Six?
No, you're right. I better make that the Guildford Four. Hello, Clive. Yeah, it's me, Meg. You anything going on up your end tonight? Well, I'm having a sophisticated dinner party. Any chance you could bring a couple of birds and a bottle? Magic. Hang on a second.
Go.
Type something. Sorry, mate. Hmm? Dorothy? No, I've chucked her. Yeah, well, when you've got the keys to the whole sweet shop, you don't just want to stuff your face with crunchies all the time, do you? Super. See you, eight-ish.
Gary, you know masturbation?
Vaguely, yes.
You know women?
Women, yes.
Well, when they do it right, they just imagine Richard Gere or Linford Christie or whatever lying on top of them, probably on a mountain top.
Or in a leafy glade.
Yeah. Something with a girly atmosphere.
Eh? Yeah. Whereas all we have to do is reach for your favourite mag and yank your plank.
I mean, it's quicker. You don't have to use your imagination. And it's good for local newsagents.
I haven't bought any, actually, since Dorothy found my collection.
Ooh, was she cross?
A little bit, yeah. She waited till I left the flat, and then she posted a magazine to every address in my file of facts. With a covering note.
Must have been a bit awkward.
Yeah. Mind you, some of my relatives were quite grateful for the mags. I know my branch of Barclays was surprised when the Christmas issue of Cheeks Apart Plus plopped onto the doormat.
Yeah. They must have been, mate.
Do you know how to make roses out of paper towels?
Nope.
Neither do I. I'll do aeroplanes.
You see, what we need is more pornography, but better, so the chicks can enjoy it as well.
What, so, like, we've got magazines like Knockers and Minge. They should have magazines like Plums Up and Wang.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, the ladies, bless them.
Bless them.
I mean, they should be able to go in the newsagent and say, I'll have Knitting Weekly, Hello, and, oh, give me a copy of this month's foreskin. Yeah.
Well, that'd be true equality, wouldn't it?
Brilliant.
Yeah. So, if somebody offered you 500 quid to pose nude in Plums Up, would you do it?
Only if it was artistic.
Yeah, me too.
You know, something like, well, I don't
know. That's very nice.
Yeah. Or, you know, I could use a chair. Something like...
That's quite sexy, actually.
Or if they wanted something a bit cheeky, I could really give it the old...
Yeah, clear of cheeky if I were you. It's a hard one to pull off.
Yeah. Better clear those mags out of my room before Jill arrives.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, Tony, I'd Anthea type up some place names for me.
Nice one, mate.
Yeah. Unfortunately, she couldn't read my handwriting. You've come out as Totty. It's there.
Jill, isn't it? Or Jilly, come through. That's right, coat's in
no.
my bed. All right, leave it. So the bathroom's in there if you want to freshen up. Note that you don't look very fresh indeed already. I'll be lighting the candle shortly, and then we'll be having some peanuts, and I thought we could kick things off with a little light conversation with the other guests. Oh, you're going to see Tony? Yes, that's fine.
Oh,
That's nice.
Hey, let me have a look, let me have a look. Oh, hey. Oh, God, you look terrific.
Shame we have to have supper.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Your flatmate's made quite an effort. He seemed excited that we were going to be having a candle.
Mate, I suppose we should really go now.
Who needs all those horrible magazines?
Hi!
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, you look lovely.
Thanks.
So, shall we do the instructions upstairs?
Oh, hello. I thought you might be the catering for my dinner party.
Gary, this is Jamie.
I used to have a moped.
It's a Harley Davidson, actually.
It's a Harley Davidson, actually.
Gary, if this is the juvenile level you want
to... I'm sorry, the juvenile level? Did you say the juvenile level? Juvenile as in what?
Juvenile as in...
I know what juvenile means! I didn't go to university.
No, you didn't, Gary.
And I'd be grateful if you keep the noise down, please, because I'm having a sophisticated dinner party tonight. I'll ask my guests if they think I'm juvenile. We can discuss that over the five-course meal and selection of fine wines from around the world.
Hello, catering.
Oh, shit.
Hi, Gary. Sorry, we're having the oven sandblasted today, so I've done you a few cold cuts. It's funny, you know. No one's ever asked me to do outside catering before. Yeah. So I made a hasty study of nouvelle cuisine. Yeah, look. Organic pilchards in a tomato coulis. Hexagons of smoked salmon drizzled in Malibu. And I made the scotch egg myself from the finest scotch. Be careful though, the egg's still got its shell on.
Hello? Clive? What do you mean you've had a better offer? What about the bird you were bringing? They are the better offer. Well, how am I supposed to find somebody at this short notice? I haven't got any other friends, Clive, and you know that, you ponce! I'll be serving the dinner. I'm going to light the candle. I'm going to light the candle now.
That dinner parties are just for people that are too lazy to have their supper in front of the television.
And the other interesting theories of his I should know about.
Yeah. He says there's no such thing as dry cleaning. All they do is fold the clothes up neatly, put them into polythene bags and hand them back to you.
So is he mad or just a bit mad?
Probably kind of
comes from hanging around with Tony. Tony started the conspiracy theory that President Kennedy wasn't shot. He was just stung by a very vicious bee.
Well, they're keeping pretty quiet downstairs.
Mm. Well, this time of night, it could go one of two ways. Either they'll collapse in an alcoholic coma or start singing the Lady in Red. Very unmusically.
I must say, I'm a bit worried about that catering. Should I get some paramedics on standby in case someone tries to eat it?
I'm gonna sit here while you make fun of my ex-boyfriend.
Where are you going to sit?
I thought I'd sit in the comfy chair over there.
Well, it must be a relief to go out with someone whose ears don't look like they've been welded on by a drunk Albanian.
No, I mean it, Jamie. Leave him alone.
Ooh!
Oh, come on, he's unhappy. I never meant for that to happen.
Hello.
Oh, hello. I thought we agreed on smart casual for this evening. You seem to be edging more into casual territory there.
Where is everybody, mate? Toilet?
Yes, that's right. I'm going to join them in a minute. We're going for the European record for the largest number of people in the toilet at a dinner party.
Sorry about me and Jill. We just felt a bit sexy, you know.
A bit sexy, you know. No, I'm sorry, that doesn't ring any bells.
Well, look, I'm here now. Is there anything I can do to help?
Well, you could try wringing the tablecloth out into that wine box, if you'd like.
I think I'll just sit down here and have a little chat, eh?
Yeah. Well, who needs company? I've got all life's essentials here. I've got a lager, a cracker and a broken plastic necklace. What else could a man want?
What's in the bag?
Huh? That's what's left of me and Dorothy.
A cat basket?
Yeah, we got that when we rescued a cat and nurtured it back to health. And that's the replacement cat we got when the one we nurtured back to health got run down by next door's camper van. Just a few items from a relationship that is no more.
Gotta hand it to you, mate. You're taking it really calmly.
Excuse me, would you? I'm just gonna go out to the shed.
Okay, mate. So that's why House of the Rising Sun sounds so crap.
You couldn't do that one thing for me, could you?
What if you chucked me? Then who would I have for company?
Ah, the ideal chance to find out.
These girls are my friends.
Well, you obviously prefer friends with staples through their tits.
No. You see, actually, there are some very interesting short stories and articles. Surprisingly educational. Look, just... Let me keep the one with Nikki and Kimberly playing snooker. Who's that to me? Oh. Yeah, well, maybe I'm not the one with the problem, pal! Sunday then.
Right. Was it?
Sorry to interrupt. Ex-boyfriend here. Don't get up. Dorothy and I still have one or two things to divide up, so I thought I'd do it in the fairest possible way. Right down the middle. All right. Shouldn't be such a bastard to put up now, should it? The kitty catty basket. Now the cat.
Ah.
Right. Either Dorothy goes out with me again, or Kitty gets it.
Okay. Come on. Come on now. There you go. Shh.
Lady in red, do not do it with me, to cheat.
Can I be honest with you, mate?
I'd be disappointed if you weren't, sir.
I'm a bit worried about you, mate.
Why?
Well, let's face it. You don't go and power saw your bird stuffing ass in the middle of a dinner party, do you? I mean, and not unless you're really stressed, eh?
Don't worry about me, old son. I will survive. I will survive!
Bastard, eh?
What, Jamie, yeah, little piggy eyes.
No.
My mate, Clive, yes.
No, mate.
Les?
No. Tony Blackburn.
What a bastard. What a wig. Wiggy, wig. I don't know why women object about all this so much, you know, because it's just women, isn't it?
Jill says it makes them look like objects.
Oh, like vases?
Yeah, vase. Nonsense, isn't it?
Cobblers.
Right. If women could only have either buttocks or breasts, what would you sacrifice?
I'd be very sad to lose my buttocks.
No. I know you would, mate. Yeah?
Can I have one of each?
You want one buttock and one breast?
Well, let's face it, there is some duplication there, isn't there?
On balance, you see, I'd rather have the breasts. Because you can look at them while you're talking to a girl, whereas with the bottom, you see, you either have to be round the back or have a photo.
That's true, that's true.
And, you know, if you push breasts together, they look a bit like a bottom.
Do they? I'll do that, then. I'm a wanker, and it does me good like it bloody well should. I'm a wanker. Wank, 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 wank